Today my guest is imprisoned journalist Emin Fethullahev's father, Emin Fethullahev. Welcome to our studio. Thank you. Yesterday you received a phone call which threatened you. How was the incident? Whom did you appeal to? Thank you for inviting me to the studio to express my opinions. Yesterday at about 6:40 a.m. in the morning, we received a phone call. My wife and last mother took the receiver. She became very white and frozen. I asked her what was happening. She told me that a woman who introduced herself as an employee of Justice Ministry and spoke in Russian told her that Enula was killed and they would be killed soon too. I was shocked at the time. It took me 5 minutes to understand what was going on, and then immediately phoned to emergency police service 102. I reported the incident to the police. I talked to them for a while and told them that I repeatedly received such phone calls and no measure is taken. They told me to write a written appeal, but I refused to do so. I told them that I asked the Interior Minister to receive me. I want to personally deliver the information that I know to him. And have you earlier received such phone calls as well? Yes, I have repeatedly received this type of phone calls, threatening calls. It's interesting that earlier, in the case of such threatening phone calls, the Criminal Investigation Department of Interior Ministry dealt with the investigation of the incident. But the last time, during the new year, in the beginning of 2011, we received such a phone call, and again, Enula's mother took the receiver, and someone told her that Enula was killed. And this time, this investigation was transferred to Yasamal District Police Office. I had submitted a written appeal to this police station number 26, but I waited for 2 hours and there were 2 months, and there was no response. 2 months later, I visited the police station and I was told that an area investigator is dealing with this issue. Did you contact the penitentiary service? No, I don't have contact with penitentiary service at all. Today, Enula's lawyer, Anar Gasimov, will visit the prison and inform Enula about it. Are you going to appeal to the law enforcement agencies to keep your phone under control so that to control the situation? You know, I must say that I feel that our phone is listened to all 24 hours a day. You know, I'm only dealing with the situation of my son, and it's very absurd to listen to my phone conversations. I have contacts with international community as well. I talk to them, I contact them, and I want to reiterate that if they listen to my phone talks, then they should know who called me and spoke to me and threatened me. And it is weird that they cannot find the persons who threaten us. And how is the situation of Enula now? He was held in a single cell for a while upon his own request, and then he was removed to shared cell. How is his health? How is his situation? Enula was moved to the single cell on March 2, and I visited the prison on March 6 and talked to the prison chief Yahraman, who I felt was a good man. I had a good conversation with him, and he told me that Enula is not awaiting in any danger, and after a while he should have moved to shared cell. Then Enula was moved to shared cell. His health situation was good, and the lawyers regularly meet with him. Recently, Anar Gasimov met with him, and his situation was good. Did you also meet with Medad Guliyev, the new chief of penitentiary service of the Justice Ministry? Yes, I appealed, and he received me. I had a conversation with him too. He made me sure that Enula is not awaiting any danger again. and that there could be no danger for him. April 20, 2011 will mark the first anniversary of NLS arrest. How many trials were held within this period, within these 4 years? You know, according to my calculations, there have been about 40 hearings. There have been hearings regarding NLS case in 4 or 5 districts of Baku. European Court was also involved. I also want to inform that I was against taking the issue to European Court. I regret that this issue was not settled here and was taken to European Court. And April 22 will mark an anniversary of European Court's judgment which demands immediate release of Fethullahev. How is the situation in this issue? Yes, in April last year, the European Court ruled for release of Fethullahev, but the government didn't agree and appealed against the decision. But European Court again approved its judgment and rejected the appeal of the government, but government didn't fulfill the judgment again. Fethullahev was not released. The drug charge prevented it. Besides, the European Council Ministerial Committee twice ruled for release of Fethullahev or replacement of the punishment, but it was not fulfilled too. As for the compensation, it has not been paid up to now. You know, in the last trial, when Enlov was sentenced to 2.5 years in jail, Enlov said that I had already served 4 years in prison, and the prosecutor told him that you received the compensation for these years, and I told him that it was very ridiculous. And recently, Ministerial Committee of the European Council ruled that the compensation money cannot be transferred to frozen accounts, but we were not provided with compensation. I read in the press that Enlov Fethullahev wants to launch a hunger strike on the anniversary of the judgment that was made by European Court for his immediate release. What is the essence of this hunger strike? What are the requirements? You know, I learned about it from the lawyer, and Enlov has no other way. He has served 4 years. He maybe wants to express his protest, but I'm against this. You know, as parents, we are always concerned that this could deteriorate his health. And you had stated that if Enlov had appealed to president, and if he is released, he could leave Azerbaijan for some other foreign country. What can you say about it? Enlov is a very well-educated and clever man, and if this state doesn't need his knowledge, he could use his knowledge, his education, in benefit of other countries. Thank you for coming to our studio. Today my guest was imprisoned journalist Enlov Fethullahev's father, Emin Fethullahev.